Now suppose if I am given a two-tube system, then I can have superposition and I can have also entanglement. So using both superposition and entanglement, I can have a random circuit. I can have as much as more complex circuit. So if I am given a, I will tell you, if there are two qubits, then according, I can take a number of layers, and also first I can create superposition set. Let me keep the incident state as 0. Then I can create a superposition set with 2. I can apply E3 operation, and then I can have the signal gate. So in this way, I can have a superposition and entanglement set. If I can see psi theta phi lambda, I can give phi lambda to be 0. I can only have the theta.
Cos theta 0 0 plus sin theta 1 0. The outcome statement is cos theta 0 0 plus sin theta 1.
Right. And again, I can repeat the same thing. Like I can repeat the same thing again and again, so many times. Now I have one question. Let me take this circuit and let me take another circuit. And tell me which one is more complex. Suppose I am repeating this circuit n times. Maybe I can here I can have u theta 2, another parameter. Then control one. U theta 3. So I can take n times, and then I can have n theta values. So when I plot the energy, I could have energy versus, and here I could have theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, up to I can have theta n, and upon those I can plot the energy values. So it can be multi-dimensional, you can imagine it. So we can also observe that as much as the number of parameters will increase, or as much as the number of layers we are taking, it is very hard to minimize the energy, because we are going to have a bigger and bigger space. When we have only one theta, then we had only one theta, so then at that in this case, we need to only calculate d by d theta 1, right? And this is equal to 0.
So why don't you take the first circuit and change the theta?
This one?
Yes.
Yeah. That is what I am doing. I am taking the first circuit and taking the theta. Theta 1, then the theta. For the second day, I am taking theta 2, theta 3, theta 4, or theta 2. This is one kind of variational circuit. At minimum I can have this kind of variational circuit, and I can repeat n times. I can have n layers, so I can have n parameters, and upon that I can minimize the energy. Also there are other possible cases of variational circuit, but we need to remember that we are going to, because as we have two qubit, we can use the power of superposition and we can use the power of entanglement. So just we have to confirm that our circuit produces a complex state having both superposition and entanglement. Okay. Now I can have another kind of layer. I can design another kind of layer. Let's suppose I can take beta 1. Maybe this one. So I can take n times. Or I can take the same parameter here, theta 1 or maybe this one with theta 1. I can also take.
So where
will
put the unitary operator
correspond
to the
Hamiltonian? Yeah, after preparation of the insert state. So after the n layer, we will be having the insert state. After then, we are going to operate the interoperator.
Sir, can we take more than two qubits in a variational circuit?
Yes, we can take it. Suppose we are taking a 3-qubit system. For variation circuit, we need to see the interoperator or we need to first see the system. How many number of qubits the system consists of? If it's a 3-qubit, then we will take a 3-qubit system, a 3-qubit state. After that, we will apply the 3-qubit interoperator. So, according to the interoperator or according to the your system, you need to take the number of qubits. So, in the 2-qubit, we can have this kind of variation circuit and we can repeat n times. And also, we can have another case where we can again take some of the units. Yeah, it's the thing that we can take. Or suppose we can here also can take some of the units. Right. This is one kind of variation circuit, both superposition and entanglement are there. Both superposition and entanglement are there. I can repeat this circuit to be n times. This circuit to be n times. So in this way, we just need, as I told, we just need to remember that we are going to use superposition and we are going to operate one operator which can create superposition and the entangled gate, like or the synod gate. Or instead of synod gate, you can use other control gate like anti-control not, or you can take control Z, or you can take any control operation. So, but in 2-qubit, you can also have a variation circuit like this one. You can create superposition, then you can again apply control Z, which takes care of both superposition and entanglement. In that also can, then again you can put another U3, then again control U3. Or simply you can take any 2-qubit, you can take maybe 0. You can only take control U3. It will get both superposition and entanglement. Or you can take Utta control U3. This kind of circuit you can repeat n times. So a number of variation circuits you can take in a particular system. So if you are given a 3-qubit system, or you can extend to n times, n qubits. Most of the people or most of the papers use this kind of operations. Like, they apply some U3, then control node, then U3, then control. Also, you can do one thing. You can calculate concurrence, right? You can calculate concurrence in a 2-qubit system. So you can calculate for which parameters your concurrence is the maximum. You can take that parameter or you can take that particular circuit and you can repeat it n times. That could create more entanglement or more complicated system. Okay. Suppose I know that here if I take theta to be pi by 2i, it will be simplified. It will be like a Hadamard. So I won't have at much of complex. So I can take some other value for which the degree of entanglement or the degree of concurrence will be higher. So those parameters I can choose I can repeat it. So I can have a maximum complex system. So in most of cases, in most of papers, people use this kind of variation circuit. And they believe that frequency this circuit. Let me write down A12. A12 means the operator is called A, and the 1 2 means this is 1 kilo, 2 kilo, up to N kilo. You can apply the same operator A12 here, then A13, then A14, then up to A(n-1), up to N. Right? Sorry, A12N. Right? And then you have to again apply that operator. So 1 2 1 3 1 4 up to 1N is done. Now you have to apply the same operator on 2 3, then on 2 4, then up to, you have to go up to 2N. Similarly, so you have to go up to, then similarly so you have to go up to N minus 1 to N. So at much amount of, I mean, in time or number of layers you can take. You could see the recent paper of the recent paper on quantum supremacy. They took an arbitrary complex state, and there also you could see their particular circuit doesn't have a particular form or particular structure. They completely take an arbitrary gates to create a maximum or a maximally complex state. So in this way, I mean, we can take any Bayesian circuit, and we can apply after that. So using Bayesian circuit, we can create a general complex system or a general complex state, and we can change the parameter. We can have a number of states, and upon them we can apply the interoperator, and then we can measure them. After measuring, we can calculate the energy values for each and every term in Hamiltonian, and we can use a classical algorithm to minimize the energy. So in this way, for any bigger system, we can take a circuit and we can calculate the energy, the minimum energy. Yeah. The minimum energy, and we can calculate the ground state energy and the fast, maybe. So in some cases, people have already calculated the fast state and second excited state. So this is they have already calculated. So we can take a look at those. In 2017, IBM also published a paper in Nature, and they calculated grams energy level of lithium hydride and beryllium hydride, which at that time was the maximum, which is the most complex molecule. Till now, people have already calculated some of the hydrogen water molecule and other complex molecules. So for any bigger system, we can use Bayesian quantum circuit to calculate the ground state energy level and ground state energy states. Yes. और ये लेक्चर होगा मैम मिल सकता है
अभी